So hi everyone and a very good evening to all of you. So as you all know, the NABARD examination is now around the corner, and if I talk about the NABARD grade A examination, then government schemes is one of the most important topics for this examination, right? So government scheme, agar aap bina kiye examination mein jaoge, then please don't go for the examination, because in that case aapka exam wo pass nahi hone wala, because that is the most important part. चाहे वो फेज वन में हो या फिर फेज टू में हो, राइट? इन फेज टू इन बोथ ESI एंड ARD सेक्शन, राइट, जो 40-40 नंबर का होता है, दोनों में गवर्नमेंट स्कीम से क्वेश्चन आते हैं, राइट? एंड ESI में तो बहुत ही ज्यादा क्वेश्चंस होते हैं. तो विदाउट गवर्नमेंट स्कीम यू कैन नॉट इमेजिन टू क्लियर दिस एग्जामिनेशन. एंड येस, टू हेल्प यू गाइज इन दिस, मैं बहुत सारे गवर्नमेंट स्कीम के सेशन ऑलरेडी लेके आ चुका हूँ, एंड इन फ्यूचर जब तक आपके एग्जामिनेशन है तब तक ये सारे के सारे सेशन चलते रहेंगे. मंडे, वेडनेसडे, फ्राइडे गवर्नमेंट स्कीम का सेशन, एंड ट्यूजडे वी हैव अ सेशन ऑन ARD करंट. कल ARD करंट का सेशन नहीं हो पाया था बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टेन रीजंस, बट वो जो कल वाला सेशन था वो कल होगा, यानी कि थर्सडे को. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट टुडे स्कीम. व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ टुडे स्कीम? इट इज DDU-GKY, दैट इज दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ग्रामीण कौशल्य योजना. इट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्कीम ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट, एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इसको काफी ज्यादा सपोर्ट करती है इस स्कीम को, राइट? सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस स्कीम. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव द PDF ऑफ दिस सेशन, यू कैन जॉइन द टेलीग्राम चैनल. द लिंक इज प्रोवाइडेड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव द ऑलराउंड प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एनी गवर्नमेंट एग्जामिनेशन, यू कैन डाउनलोड द अनुजिंदल ऐप फ्रॉम द गूगल प्ले स्टोर, राइट? एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस स्कीम. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डू दोज थिंग्स दैट वी कैन डू एफर्टलेसली, एंड देन वी विल मूव अहेड टू द थिंग्स दैट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर, राइट? This way you can minimize the things that you have to remember by understanding the things from the scheme, right? So first of all, if I talk about the objective, the objective to bahut hi aasan hota hai determine karna. It's very easy to determine. From the name we can derive the objective. It is DDU Grameen Kaushalya Yojana. DDU is the name of a person, of course we all know, the great Deendayal Upadhyay. And forget about Yojana, it means scheme. Now there are two keywords here only, Grameen and Kaushalya. What is the meaning of Grameen? That's very easy. Grameen ka matlab hota hai rural. The meaning of Grameen is what? Rural, right? Then what is the meaning of Kaushalya? Kaushalya means what? Skill development, which means it is a skill development scheme, right? It is clear. One thing is clear from the name of the scheme, that it is a skill development scheme for the rural areas. Now rural areas ki to of course skill development nahi hogi. The skill can be developed of a person, right? So it is a skill development program for rural youths across the country, right? It is a skill development program for rural youths across the country, thereby enhancing their income and providing them with the livelihood opportunities, or you can say thereby providing them with the livelihood opportunities and enhancing their income. All right, so that is the objective of this scheme. I hope the objective is clear. And since we are talking about rural youths, then of course the nodal ministry to implement this scheme is Ministry of Rural Development, right? And this ministry is headed by Mr. Giriraj Singh. Okay, minister is who? Mr. Giriraj Singh, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai in Bihar, right? So this is the objective. I hope the objective is clear. Moving ahead to some of the most important key features of this particular scheme, jo ki aap ek bar bhi padh loge to aapko dimag mein ye reh jayega, because these are some unique features of this scheme, right? So what are these features? Number one, the skill training which is provided under this scheme to the rural youth is absolutely free of cost, which means the entire funding is borne by the central government. Now you must be wondering, central government, state government ka kya koi share nahi hai? Yes. See, remember one thing, that DDU-GKY, this scheme DDU-GKY is being implemented under DNRLM, which is an umbrella scheme of the Ministry of Rural Development. DNRLM is what? Deendayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Rural Livelihood Mission. So it is a part of DNRLM, and DNRLM is a centrally sponsored scheme. Centrally sponsored scheme, which means centrally sponsored scheme, which means the funding is shared between the center and the states, right? So जो भी DNRLM के पास पैसा आता है उस पैसे में से DDU-GKY को पैसा दिया जाता है, राइट? द फंडिंग ऑफ DDU-GKY इज बीइंग डन फ्रॉम DNRLM स्कीम, राइट? बिकॉज दैट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ DNRLM. ऑलराइट, सो अंडर DDU-GKY द स्किल ट्रेनिंग इज एब्सोल्युटली फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. देयर इज नो कॉस्ट ऑफ ट्रेनिंग. which has to be given by the beneficiary. Then mandatory coverage of socially disadvantaged groups, like for example, at least 50% of the beneficiary should be from SC or ST community. At least 33% of the total beneficiary should be women, minority 15%, and person with disability is 3%. So it is the mandatory coverage. मतलब इतने लोग तो होने ही चाहिए. Like for example, if the government is providing training to 100 people, then out of those 100 people, 50 should be from SC or ST community, right? And then there is a guaranteed placement also after providing training. ठीक है, ऐसा नहीं है कि training देके सरकार ने छोड़ दिया, because सिर्फ ट्रेनिंग देने से लाइवलीहुड अपॉर्चुनिटी तो आई नहीं, राइट? या फिर उनका इनकम तो एनहांस हुआ नहीं, क्योंकि इसके ऑब्जेक्टिव में हमने तीन चीजें पढ़ी. नंबर वन, टू प्रोवाइड स्किल ट्रेनिंग, टू यू नो प्रोवाइड द लाइवलीहुड अपॉर्चुनिटी, एंड टू इनहांस द इनकम, राइट? तो अगर सिर्फ ट्रेनिंग दे देंगे, उससे इनकम कैसे इनहांस होगी, राइट? तो उसके लिए जॉब भी तो देनी पड़ेगी. सो देर इज अ गारंटीड प्लेसमेंट फॉर एटलीस्ट 75% ऑफ द ट्रेन्ड कैंडिडेट्स विद अ मिनिमम सैलरी ऑफ रुपीज 6,000 पर मंथ. मिनिमम 6,000 पर मंथ की नौकरी सरकार इसमें मिनिमम 75% लोगों को दिलवाती है जिनको सरकार ने ट्रेनिंग दी है, राइट? नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन मॉडल, सो फ्रॉम सेंटर टू द ग्रास रूट लेवल देर आर वेरियस डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसीज. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एट नेशनल लेवल वी हैव DDU GKY नेशनल यूनिट. And this unit has the responsibility of policy making, implementation guidelines, right? Basically, the objective of this DDU-GKY national unit is to formulate the guidelines of this particular scheme. Then at the state level, we have DDU-GKY state missions, which these missions are providing implementation support at the grassroots level, right? And finally, we have project implementing agencies, right? Which have the responsibility of implementing this scheme. ठीक है, जो final implementation है scheme का वो कौन करता है? Project implementation agencies. And these project implementation agencies are being selected by, or you can say have been selected by the government. ठीक है, ये government द्वारा selected होते हैं. Alright. So this is the implementation model. Moving ahead to the things that you have to remember, and among all the things that you have to remember, the most important part is the launch year. It was launched in 2014 on Antyodaya Divas, that is 25th September, the birth date of Deendayal Upadhyay ji, right? And of course, as I told you, it is being implemented under the NRLM. So do remember the launch year, and in this case, in the case of this scheme, do remember the launch date as well, because that is a special date, 25th September, that is observed as Antyodaya Divas in the country, right? Now talking about the eligibility, क्या सारे rural youth को इसमें benefit दिया जाएगा? तो yes, almost all the rural youths will be provided, benefited under this scheme. जैसे कि rural youth, जो age group 15 to 35 के बीच में है, कोई भी चलेगा, right? And then, if it is a case of SC, ST, women, particularly vulnerable tribal group, PVTG, person with disability, transgender, or other any special group, like for example bonded labor है, manual scavenger है, victim of human trafficking है, etc. In these cases, right, the age limit is extended by 10 years, that is up to 45 years, right? So rural youth के लिए normal अगर youth है तो the age limit is 15 to 35 years, while if it is a special case, then in that case the upper age limit is 45 years. Alright, and the scheme is being implemented currently as per a PIB release in 27 states and 3 UTs across the country. अगर आप DDU-GKY की वेबसाइट देखोगे तो वहां पे मेंशन है 28 states and UTs. Right, 28 states and UTs. But as per the recent release in PIB by the Ministry of Rural Development, it is being implemented in 27 states and 3 UTs across the country. Right? Moving ahead to the special initiative. Now these are the three special initiatives which are being implemented under DDU-GKY. Number one, we have Himayat, which is a special scheme for rural and urban youth in Jammu and Kashmir. Then we have Roshni, which is a special initiative for rural youth of poor families in left-wing extremist districts across 9 states. Now left-wing extremist district ka matlab hota hai the districts which are disturbed due to Naxalism, right? And finally, in the Northeast region, 10% of DDU GKY program funds are reserved for projects in the Northeast. Matlab, out of all the funds which are allocated for DDU GKY, 10% will always be used for the projects in Northeastern region. Alright? And now let's talk about some other important key features of this scheme, like for example, the trainings. The government is providing training, the project implementing agencies are providing training. Now there should be some curricular of that training, no? Right? So the trainings are provided in accordance with curriculum as recommended by National Council for Vocational Training or as identified in the qualification pack, which are developed by Sector Skills Council of National Skill Development Corporation. Right? So two alag-alag sources hai of the curriculum. Number one, either National Council for Vocational Training or qualification packs developed by Sector Skill Council of NSDC. Alright, and no training fee is levied on the beneficiary. We have already discussed kar liya, and 100% DDU GKY subsidizes 100% cost of skill training of candidate at its approved training center. But in this case, of course, देखो अब भारत सरकार आपको ट्रेनिंग दे रही है तो आप क्लासेस को बंक तो करोगे नहीं. ऐसा तो है नहीं कि हम घर पे चिल कर रहे हैं, हमारी वहां पे अटेंडेंस लग रही है स्कूल कॉलेज की तरह. ऐसा नहीं हो सकता. द बेनिफिशियरी हैज टू मेंटेन एटलीस्ट 70% अटेंडेंस, एटलीस्ट 50% अटेंडेंस एंड 70% मार्क्स इन द फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन. राइट? एटलीस्ट 50% उसकी अटेंडेंस होनी चाहिए और 70% उसके मार्क्स होने चाहिए इन द फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन. ओनली देन उसके आगे उसकी प्लेसमेंट वगैरह की बात होगी या फिर पोस्ट प्लेसमेंट सपोर्ट भी दी जाएगी. ऑलराइट? सो एटलीस्ट 50% अटेंडेंस एंड 70% मार्क्स इन फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. ऑलराइट, मूविंग अहेड टू अदर की फीचर्स. सो देयर इज अ ड्यूरेशन ऑफ कोर्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग. सो देयर आर वेरियस टाइप ऑफ ट्रेनिंग्स व्हिच आर बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड विद डिफरेंट ड्यूरेशंस. लाइक वी हैव 3 month ट्रेनिंग ऑफ 576 आवर्स, 6 month ट्रेनिंग ऑफ 1152 आवर्स, 9 month training of 728 hours and 12 month training of 2304 hours. And there is a provision of on the job training as well, which means the beneficiary will before joining a job will have the industry exposure. Right? So on the job training ki agar hum baat kare, so in the 576 hours training, 30 days is on the job training, 1152 hours mein 60 days is the job on the job training, 728 hours 90 days and 2304 hours 120 days on the job training is provided to the beneficiaries. Alright, aage chalte. Now there is a provision of post placement support as well, which is rupees 1000 per month, and rupees 1000 per month is provided as this post placement support. After getting placed, the beneficiary is getting rupees 1000 per month for a period of 2 months in case the beneficiary is placed within the district of domicile. Right? He will get support for 3 months if placed within the state of domicile, and he will get this support for a period of 6 months in case the placement is outside the state of domicile. Alright? And finally, placement could also be done in a foreign country with a minimum salary of US$500 per month. That depends on the employer. अगर employer चाहता है कि वो beneficiary को बाहर भेजे तो वो भेज सकता है. Alright? So guys, that is all about the scheme. I hope the scheme is clear. इससे ज़्यादा detail में आपसे कोई नहीं पूछेगा, और अगर पूछेगा तो मत करके आना, because that cannot be done. मैं हमेशा कहता हूँ कि गधे वाली मेहनत मत किया करो. इस पे ये जो scheme है इसका document around 80 pages का है. You can't mug up the entire document. Right? That is not possible at all. तो इसमें यही चीजें हैं जो कि आपके एग्जाम में पूछी जाएंगी. एंड दिस आई एम टेलिंग यू गाइस विद माय एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ गिविंग द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ टीचिंग द स्टूडेंट्स. दोनों एक्सपीरियंस है मेरे पास. राइट? सो हैव सम फेथ और ये सब कुछ करके जाओ. नाउ लेट्स रिवाइज इट वंस अगेन. द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस स्कीम इज टू प्रोवाइड स्किल ट्रेनिंग टू द रूरल यूथ्स, देयर बाय प्रोवाइडिंग देम विद द लाइवलीहुड अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड एनहांसिंग देयर इनकम. इट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट. द ट्रेनिंग इज प्रोवाइडेड एट फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट एंड देयर इज अ mandate to cover socially disadvantaged groups, SC/ST 50%, women 33%, minority 15%, and PWDs 3%. And guaranteed placement, there is a provision of guaranteed placement to at least 75% of the trained beneficiary with minimum salary rupees 6000. This is the implementation model. We have DDU GKY national unit, we have DDU GKY state mission and then we have project implementing agency. It was launched in the year 2014 on 25th September, that is observed as Antyodaya Divas across the country. Eligibility, any rural youth between the age group of 15 and 35. This age group is the upper age limit is 45 years in case of special cases, right? And it is being implemented in 27 states and 3 UTs across the country. These are 3 special initiatives under this scheme, and the curriculum is provided as per National Council for Vocational Training or as per qualification packs of Sector Skill Council, right? You have to score, the beneficiary has to score at least 70% marks in the final examination and has to maintain at least 50% attendance, right? These are the duration of the training which is being provided. Post placement support is also provided, 1000 per month, and there is a provision of foreign placement as well with minimum salary of US$500 per month. Alright, and now let's do this question. Parul belongs to Vinaynagar village of Faridabad district in Haryana. She is currently 16 years old. So she is from rural area. First of all, she is from rural village. Of course, she is from village, which means she is from rural area, right? She is currently 16 years old. Due to poor financial condition of her family, she is looking for some livelihood opportunities, right? Being so young, she does not have any skill which can get her to a job. Of course, she is 16 years old. We can't expect that she has a skill hoga bahut hi tagda. One day, her friend Haneet told her about a scheme being implemented by Ministry of Rural Development under DNRLM. Under the scheme, skill trainings are being provided to eligible rural youths. After training, government is also providing placement with a predetermined minimum salary of ₹6,000 per month. Not only this, post placement support is also provided. What financial assistance per month is provided to the beneficiary as post placement support under the scheme mentioned by Harneet? Now, this scheme, because we have just discussed the scheme, but during the examination, it will be considered as a difficult question. Why? Because you have to identify the scheme and then you have to answer this. Aur itna lamba passage hai, padhte padhte time bahut zyada lagta hai, right? So in this case, you have to identify, you have to focus on the keywords. Which keywords are mentioned? See, always you would have sufficient hints in your question. Okay, itne hints aapke paas honge that you are eligible to that you are able to identify the scheme, right? So jaise ki agar hum keywords ki baat kare, so we have first of all ministries given. Right, first hint is ministry, then second hint is the objective, skill trainings are being provided to eligible rural youth. So two hint ho gaye. After training, government is also providing placement with a predetermined minimum salary of 6000 per month, third hint ho gaya, and then post placement support, fourth hint ho gaya. So itne sare hint hai already, so you can easily identify the name of the scheme. So now the answer to this question is option D, because the question is regarding what is the post placement support, right? So option D is the correct answer. Alright guys, so that's it for today's session. I hope the scheme is clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And tomorrow there will be a session on ARD current affairs, which Tuesday ko nahi ho paya tha. Alright. So thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.